Največji delež pogače pa dobi podjetje KBR, ki skrbi za logistično podporo vojske. Do sedaj so opravili že za 12 milijard dolarjev del, ki omogočajo, da vojna poteka nemoteno. Podjetje skrbi, da vojaki ne bi ostali prepuščeni sami sebi. Ironično je, da vojska vitalno oskrba svojih enot, ki so v osrčju sovražnega ozemlja, zaupa najboljšemu ponudniku. Očitno si tudi najmočnejša vojska na planetu ni zmožna več sama dobavljati toaletnega papirja.
Reached Kellogg Browning Root Overseas Employment Hotline for LogCap 3.
The biggest contract in Iraq is with Halliburton subsidiary KBR, a logistics company that provides support for U.S. troops around the world.
We are hiring for operations in Iraq, Kuwait, Afghanistan, Uzbekistan, and Djibouti.
KBR is still hiring.
Living conditions in the Middle East are extremely harsh. Iraq and Kuwait are located in a desert climate with an average temperature of 120 degrees.
So far, KBR has been asked to perform nearly $12 billion worth of services.
Afghanistan and Iraq are listed as hazard zones by the Department of State. Therefore, you will receive hazard pay. To return to the main menu, press 1.
KBR is the military's lifeline, its main supplier. KBR's convoys don't use private security. They are provided military escorts.
This is what you'll get. This is what you'll get. This is what you'll get.
KBR je tako zgradil kamp Anakondo, oziroma, kot ga nekateri ljubkovalno imenujejo, Fort KBR, kjer živi 28 tisoč vojakov in 8 tisoč najemnikov. To malo mesto ima vse, kar sodobni človek potrebuje. Fitness, plesne tečaje, fast food verige imajo tam svoje izpostave. Za občutek masovnosti poslušajmo opis Rasla Begerlija, ki skrbi za vso logistiko KBR-a.
This is huge. This is bigger than the biggest logistics operation that there is. This is World War scale logistics boiled down to a very refined process. All commodities in, all commodities out, personnel in, personnel out, military equipment in, military equipment out. We provide movement control reports on the movement of everything.
Kar pa vse skupaj naredi še bolj izkrivljeno, pa je dejstvo, da je KBR hčerinsko podjetje ameriškega Halliburtona, katerega predsednik je bil svoj čas tudi sedanji ameriški podpredsednik Dick Cheney. Rizična plača, ki jo dobivajo zaposleni v KBR-u, se je izkazala za še bolj rizično, saj nekateri izmed šoferjev sploh niso dočakali. Iz rok jim je spolzila nekje na pol poti proti Babilonu. 9. aprila so namreč padli v zasedo in, bi se reklo, preko pogodbe pogumno umrli za kogarkoli že so.
After the April 9th incident, we were told that scores of KBR truckers refused to drive until security improved. Hundreds of contractors left the country. For weeks, the military was left with dwindling stores of ammunition, fuel, and water.
Pogodbeni delavci in pogodbeni vojaki imajo torej samo njim lastno pravico, da brez vprašanj zapustijo svoje delovno mesto. To vnaša v delovanje sistema nemir in nesigurnost, kar vsekakor podaljšuje agonijo vojne in vse večjo apatijo javnosti do tega, kar se dogaja.
contractor is not part of the chain of command, and they can decide to leave when and where they want. They can decide to leave if they get a better job offer by another private military company or by some other company back home. They can decide to leave because they're just tired of this. These are all decisions that a contractor has the discretion to make that someone within the military does not. And so what you've done is put a level of uncertainty into your military operation. And military operations are not a place that you want uncertainty.
Glavna težava privatnih vojakov pa je vsekakor njihova nedotakljivost in delovanje izven območja odgovornosti. Zaradi tega so postali zelo zaželena tarča Iračanov, ki imajo takih posebnežev dovolj že iz obdobja vladavine Sadama Huseina. Kot vedno, v podobnih primerih so ljudje po sili razmer prevzeli pobudo, a zaradi tega še niso barbari ali pa kljub vsemu so. Še vselej do sedaj so bili namreč resnični barbari tisti, ki so druge označili za barbare. Bes in kri, v tem primeru pa še kanček vročine, so še vsakogar naredili lačnega, krvi namreč. Razlika je zgolj, da ena stran igro igra za denar, druga pa po sili razmer in zgolj za dušo. Intervjuji in izjave so bile vzete iz dokumentarcev Private Warriors in Iraq for Sale. Povezave do obeh dokumentarcev najdete na www.radiostudent.si na spletni verziji Zeitgeista, ki bo na voljo v celoti v obliki filmčkov za YouTube. Po divjem vzhodu sta surfala Andraš in Anže.